Hey guys, this is David Kwan, here to talk about my experience with Dark Souls, which actually wasn't, I didn't have much of an experience with it, because I did give up really early on in the game. But the reason is not because I found Dark Souls to be too punishing, and it's not really because, I guess it is true, I didn't give Dark Souls much of a chance. So the blame is kind of on me. I don't blame the game, I don't think it's a terrible game, but you do have to also understand that I played through Demon Souls, and I really enjoyed my experience with Demon Souls. So, Dark Souls is kind of like it's almost like, you know, Dark Souls and Demon Souls are very, very, very similar games. It's just, some aspects are very different, but I would pretty much say they're like similar type of games. So, you know, I really liked Demon's Souls. I found it kind of cheap and unfair at times, but it's you know, the two are the same type of games. And I completed Demon's Souls, and I was playing through my second time, you know, a new game plus before my PS3, you know, caught the YLD. But I gave up on Dark Souls early on, not because I don't like this type of gameplay. I why do you think I was playing through Dark Souls? Because I like Demon's Souls. I wanted to try out the spiritual sequel. The reason is because, and it's a graphical issue, I didn't have the patience to overcome this. I wish, perhaps later in the future, when I do get my PS3 fixed, or get a new PS3, eventually, after that happens, perhaps I will give Dark Souls another go. And maybe I'll bear through it this time. But it was a graphical issue that really just made me quit. And that's the frame rate issue. In a game like Demon's Souls or Dark Souls, frame rate has to be consistent. Because one little single mistake and you're dead in this game. These two games, you know, Demon's Souls, Dark Souls, are very punishing games. And you learn from the experience as you go. There's a lot of spots, you know, in certain levels just like, oh my gosh, I stepped on this trap, and this border comes, you know, this ball comes rolling down and kills me. Well, now I know. I can revisit that section, and I know what's going to happen. And there is a certain amount of trial and error, but there's also a certain amount of being really precise with your combat movement and you know, those kind of things. So, Demon's Souls, I had no problem. I learned the game. It was pretty brutal and difficult at times. And I did use a pretty cheap class. I used the Royalist class. I could throw, you know, I could use the magic, and I had a ring that regenerated my magic. So, yeah, I did play the game in a cheap manner, but I did still enjoy it. You know, I still had that visceral experience of making a hit, you know, and dodging and going around and blocking and making the right time movements to take an enemy down. It's still a challenging game, no matter what class you use. It's an extremely challenging game. I don't diss that. Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. I like that. But Dark Souls got to a point where in the beginning it was just, you know, you're in that large open area and the frame rate just kept, it was not consistent. It was stuttering, and I would hit a guy, like, I'd swing, but it would be like, like, it was so just, that really took me out, because I would be dying. I mean, sure, I would be making mistakes, but I would be dying also because of the frame rate. I was not able to respond the best way possible because of the lag and the frame rate issue. So I played Dark Souls for about, I want to say about 3 or 4 hours total. I never got too far. It is a big game, so 4 hours isn't much for a game like Dark Souls. But because of a frame rate issue, I gave up. And I was just like, I'm going to return this to Gamefly. Which is odd, because Demon's Souls is one of those games I did rent from Gamefly, and then I ended up keeping it. I paid Gamefly, and I bought Demon's Souls and kept it. But Dark Souls, I ended up returning it, and I haven't played it since. So I wonder if the frame rate issue was just that copy of Dark Souls that I had, or if it actually is a problem with everyone who played through Dark Souls, but you just had the patience to weather through it, and you just got used to the frame rate stutters that this game has. I don't know. And I wonder if I give it a try again, would I be... Because normally, I can play through games... I mean, for God's sakes, I play games on live. And on live, depending on the internet connection, it can get... Lag can be really, really bad. I can stomach past it. But if for some reason, Dark Souls is a game where a frame rate issue really matters. Like, that can kill you. Because any single mistake you make in this game, you just die. And if it's my mistake, I accept it. But if it's a mistake that happened just because of a frame rate stutter, I'm going to get pissed. And I did get pissed, and I stopped playing Dark Souls. So, that's my reason why I gave up on Dark Souls early on. Nothing on the game. I think it's awesome that it's a bigger universe. There's a lot of mechanics in Dark Souls that I started noticing that's just like, wow, this is really cool. Like the bonfire mechanic and being able to upgrade flasks. Dark Souls is a huge sequel. There's a lot of new features, new additions that really awesome. And some of the boss fights that I had, I was just like, this is really fun. The bosses are really unique, and the level design seems to be much more open-ended. And just, you can explore, and there's so many nuances to Dark Souls. It's just that one graphical issue just made me quit. I know it might sound like a pretty lame excuse to you guys, but that's why I ended up not going through, playing through Dark Souls all the way. That's what happened. But yeah.
Cheers.